Hi. Webcam. Seriously, this isn't going to become my catchphrase. I will keep forgetting that. Okay, now here I am at home. Happened since yesterday, so I attended a lecture with Stuart at UCA. If you fancy popping into your local university, ask them nicely. You can see some quite interesting people talk. It was a film critic. It's very interesting. Then, before that happened, Stuart pulled all my records into a couple of stacks, and so they're not really organised anymore. I'm sure it won't take as long. Today, I was going to show you something I made. I thought I might as well try and pimp some of my own stuff, but I couldn't find all the bits and pieces, so the house needs a bit of organising before that happens. So today, I don't really know what I'm going to do. Maybe I'll show you some of the things that are in here. Through them. I don't want to. Well, I'll tell you what, I'll show you a few of my singles first because I'm sure there's a few there. Singles are a lot harder because I actually like keeping all of those. Right, now here we have Nothing Compares to You, which is actually written by Prince. Although Sinead does a much better version. It did come with some badges and a poster. Don't know where those are. Now, already, one of my collection of funny novelty singles. I think I'm going to put those in a separate pile, basically. Joni Mitchell. Now, I did listen to that album yesterday. That I wasn't sure about. Never listened to it. It was horrible. Hippie shit, basically. I can't get into that now. Best left in the 60s. Having said that, Big Yellow Taxi by Joni Mitchell, still very relevant. Duran Duran, Save a Prayer. Oh, yeah, I saw these guys in a little pub near Southwold in Suffolk. And well, so seeing these guys, it was just the one guy, it's just that guy. And talked to him for a bit. My friend Zero drew him a little portrait, and he was so impressed, he gave us that. Axel F. Played that one over and over again, that'll be scratched to pieces. When Without Hats, Pop Goes the World, another very poignant single, very, very good little poppy ditty. I wonder, maybe I should play out with that. Lady Madonna and the Beatles, blimey. This is where, yes, it's an original, but it is actually scratched to pieces, completely unplayable. eBay, well, I'd say it's scratched to pieces. Queen, another one bites the dust. Now, my friend Anthony had a big clear out of his records, and I was able to snag a few of these. That's in pretty good condition. So keep that. I guess these will go in alphabeticals. Look at that, Tom's Diner, featuring Susan Vega. That is a classic. Do, 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 do. China Girl by David Bowie, one of the artists I recently worked with at Tapescape. That's her favourite tune. George Harrison, Got My Mind Set on You. I do seem to get crushes on people quite often. And I remember a particular, well, I think my first proper crush. I'm not going to go into the details, but that was the song that really meant so much to me. And maybe I'll get some of my crushes involved in the show and they can talk about how silly I am. Taffy, I Love My Radio. Looks like a promo disc. It's not bad. Maybe if I can get rights to actually, play music. I don't know. I've got to check that out. I'll go, actually go like a whole. It was a whole set. Yellow, Tied Up. That's good. J. Cole's band, Centerfold. Love Runs Cold. My memory. I'm getting bored, so I'll try and do something different in a minute. Lessons in Love, Level 42. You see, all these are keepers. Orbital. Think that's Satan and Belfast. MV side. New Shoes, I Can't Wait, another classic pop ditty. If you ask for these, if you go to your local Chicago Rock Cafe, they might have it. If they play it, the floor's going to go off.
I'll be there.
The Wombles. Womble, Borrow, Boogie, and Minuetto Allegretto. Oh, that brings back lots of memories. That's from my childhood. Very badly scratched. Mm. Produced and arranged by Mike Batt. I think he's still knocking around. Getting Away With It, Electronic, very good. Adamant Apollo 9, that's when he went solo. I suppose it's all right. Okay, I've had enough of that. Now, I guess I could give you a teaser of the fish tank, because I guess I'm quite proud of it. Hang on a sec, wait there a second. It all came about because of this, Galaxy Invader 1000. And it's an old handheld game I've pestered my parents for quite a long time. As many things in my possession around this era, it was a lot of work went into getting them. Got some of them. Some of the ones I didn't get, I actually bought at car boot sales for about £1. But I think that was £20 when it came out. And we did a bit of reading of text. I'm not really remembering things. I'm sure it was someone very important and critical about the found objects and how found objects quite often quite beautiful, and but you don't necessarily realise the beauty in them. Hence the reasons they're found, if shown in a certain way. Da 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 da. Anyway, so saw this and I was thinking of tropical fish. I used to keep tropical fish. The webcam and suddenly it tied in with these, so I actually stuck them in an old fish tank, and within the fish tank I cut up bits of my first computer. I destroyed my first computer. I thought I would actually end up and the screen's gone into screensaver mode. I thought I would end up I have to change that. I'm not going to do it now. I thought I'd train of thought. So anyway, I stuck them in a tank with the bits of my first computer, there we go, and I was going to get it fixed and be able to play all the old games. You can't play the old games on the new computers because the new version of Windows doesn't allow you to use the old version of Windows, so I've got a whole stack of games that are no good, but I'm going to keep hold of them until someone, I'm sure someone's done it, but anyway, I can get to play some of the classics again. Anyway, there it was, bits of my old computer. Hanging in, a bit like, hang on a sec, here's the guts of it. So if you can imagine this, okay, take the top off, and imagine this, just hanging there, not doing anything, you see? So then I thought, what if I could do an animation? So I did an animation. I stuck it on a white stick and I flapped it around a bit, filmed it with a camera that does slow motion. And then I stuck it in this editing program, sort of got the background to disappear with the white stick. Because I don't want to go into all too many details about that. And copied it. And so I had this little video piece. Then I had a monitor I bought from... I'm not very good at this today. I'm feeling a bit tired actually, but I'm still carrying a crack on. Might fall asleep midway through it. So anyway, auction house in Maidstone. They have all sorts of bargains, and I picked up a monitor for £3. I thought for £3, I don't care if it works or it doesn't, and it didn't work. So what I did was, I figured, well, I'll keep hold of it, you never know, I might get it fixed. Then all of a sudden it hit me, I bet you the reason it's not working is because the backlight's broken. Now, backlights of LCD monitors are the things that give it the light behind it. Otherwise, it's just a sheet of glass. Yeah, you got me? Sheet of glass with all the things happening in it, and it's the light that shines through it that gives you the colours. And from previously dismantling a broken laptop, I realised that without the light, you can basically have images floating mid-air, which just looks kind of cool. So I took the back off, and I carefully glued the monitor into the fish tank, just the glass. Then the gubbins, I had to put... I'll show you the secret. It's not really a secret. I stuck the gubbins of the LCD monitor into the top there. It's just in the lid. All this gubbins does nothing. That's just the old PC taken to bits. That's the bit that runs the monitor. If I turn it around, you see? Even got DVI. Now to feed it, because it was going to be sitting in the UCA gallery possibly. It's been all over the world. It's been to Margate as well now. All over Kent, virtually. And so there we are. And I plugged in my first ever little laptop that I had, little EPC that went around the world with me. Plugged that into it, and then I rendered a whole new animation with this. But then I thought, maybe that's not enough. I'll just get the other thing, show you what I did with it, and then I'll mimic what they were doing on the screen. Bearing in mind, I had to duplicate them as well. Race and Chase, this is one of the most unforgiving games you can ever get, because basically it wipe you out. There's no way many times to get past the cars to speed up to the bad car, because you just can't do it. You just can't. It's like, oh, it's complete luck, really. So here we go. We're going to mimic it. Pretend there's nothing behind it, okay? So we've got this one coming in. Slowly followed by another one. Let's come to screensaver mode again. Then suddenly, all of a sudden, it's coming. You see? And that happens. And then a baby, one of these, comes in and starts following this one. And that one just goes like that. Now, I couldn't do 3D animation. So what I did was when I flipped it, it was just same image backwards, but then all the text went backwards as well, but it's fine. 3D, I'm not going to spend all my life sorting, working out new things. But my favourite bit was when this, actually, about there, when the little one goes like this, and then, and then they sort of end up bottom and that swims off, and then I just looped it. It was only 2 minutes long. So all that's happening on there, and the light, I'll get this up and running the next time. I won't show you all this getting together now. Oh yeah, one of the interesting things is, from the back, even with the light on, you get a reflection. You can't see through it, but the front you can. So I'll stick one of these security lights on it. There you go. Then that back acts as the backlight of the monitor. So it looks like the fishes or video games are floating in thin air. I don't know how that came together, but I'm really proud of it. And as it's, you know, you can use it as a computer, honestly. You don't have to just show floaty fishes in an animation. You can do anything with it. Okay, I'm going to talk about one of the objects here. Actually upset one of the Christians that came around recently. That's fine. I'm kind of believing a lot of that stuff myself, but I just think a lot of damage is being done in being passionate about things like that. I can't show you it again. No, it's going well. I can't show it in all its glory because I nicked the fuse for something else. Now, I'm a member of this site called Couchsurfing, and there's a guy who came with his girlfriend, and his pitch for staying was, I'll give you 2 hours of free tattoo work, or and my girlfriend will cook you lovely food. So they were welcome to stay. In fact, they stayed 2 nights, which was lovely. And I was going to have a Vectrex tattooed on my arm because I was going through my Vectrex stage at that moment. Sort of exploring the love for an object, which got a bit intense actually at one point, but it would have been incredibly intense if I'd gone for the tattoo. But anyway, I chickened out, and then I was like, oh, can I have a QR code, please? Because I already worked out the QR code for my nickname, Johnny P. And he said, well, you don't want that because they might change the protocols, and then no one will be able to read it. It'll just be a splat on your arm. So nice one for that. And then eventually he saw this pig. My dad had just dropped it off because he didn't want it. Now, if my dad doesn't want something, you know, it's real trashed because he's worse than me at hoarding. But for some reason, he decided this wasn't for him. And Joe saw it and he went mad. I'm sure he won't mind me mentioning his name, Joe Quinn. Very, very nice guy. And so he said, I'll do the pig. So he had some markers. And he said he'd actually practiced himself on shop room dummies, mannequins and things like that. So this was perfect. So I can't show you it up, so I can't show you the offending thing that upset the Christian yet. Bacon on the back. Nice little design round there. Can't see it clearly there. Your mum, anarchy symbol. Underneath, his favourite band is Slayer, so he's given me a little Slayer under the neck. And then on the top there, you can't really see it. It's a pentangle, which with what looks like at first glance could be 666, but as it's a pig, it says 999. Do you get that? And he's put his little autograph in there. When that's lit up, which it will happen when I bother to put the fuse back in it. I probably nicked the fuse for one of the turntables from yesterday. I can get round to fixing those. Let's see what else. What's the time now? Oh dear. Oh, I'm not feeling it today, but you know, I'm going to carry on. Okay. Here we go. Now, we've all seen one of these, so I hope you have anyway. Thing for capturing 3D objects. So I think this was probably about a fiver in a car boot, so you know, you put your hand in it and there you go. Put your face in it. How's that? There we are. Generate an app for that. Now, I thought it was nice to have my face up on the wall, which it was. But one day, I thought, I want to see how noticeable things are to people. Okay? So, naturally, I gave myself an erection and I did my cock. Now, I'm just up for things like that. I mean, no one's going to see my naked cock. They just saw pins in a weird shape. It took ages and ages and ages. And then at one party, my friend Lisa noticed it and just said, is that what I think it is? And then I burst out laughing and that was it. Job done. Went back to being my face. And I don't know. Things like that sort of cheer me up. I don't know. It's a fine art between offending and just having a laugh, and I think that line's becoming a bit blurred at the moment for me, because, I don't know, it's just nice to shock sometimes. I mean, life's so banal and boring a lot of the time. I mean, you can get into trouble, though, for just the slightest things, you know, these days. Because, let's face it, we're buggered. Buggered. That's such being controlled in virtually every way possible.
Oh, this is lovely. This is
my friend Dougie Slocum. He got married very sneakily and suddenly, one of these private weddings, which I think are great because you just do it. You don't have to spend 20 grand on just showing everyone a nice time. A big piss up. I'm allowed to say that. I guess piss. He did it beautifully on the lighthouse in Dungeness with his girlfriend, now wife, and their parents. And sneakily, he made this with one of these cutters. And that's really lovely, isn't it? And it says at the top, Claire and Doug are delighted to announce they got married. So there we are. And then they went off to Turkey for a nice little holiday. So, I mean, things like that. People give me things like that, and they are absolutely beautiful. The trouble is, of course, do I keep it? Of course I do. Of course I keep it. The amount of effort that's gone into that. Like, I've kept countless birthday cards and the odd Valentine card and things like that. But I've been a bit gung-ho from time to time. And I think when I do a proper clear out, I'm sorry, Dougie and Claire. Actually, I can stick it in a folder. Why not? I'll stick it in a folder. But, I mean, I shouldn't. It is beautiful. But it is the moment. You see that. You appreciate the beauty. Even showing it to other people doesn't feel like they're going to get much out of it. You know, it's like, but would you show people your birthday cards? Would you say, oh, look at this wonderful birthday card? Unless it was particularly smutty, and then you might. Okay. Running out of steam. Okay, so I'm not sure where my phone is at the moment, so I dug this one old one out. And the great thing about this is the battery lasts for ages. I think they're made in India. The bad thing about them is that you can't really write things very well. So if I was to say, do my name, whoops, he said. Okay, I'll show that to you. Can you see that? It's old style sort of LED text, which is fine, but it means that when you're texting people, I'm guessing when they get the text, it's actually shouting at them. It's always going to be in capitals. But for an emergency phone, that's fine. Fortunately, I hadn't used it for over 6 months and my SIM was deleted. Apparently my number's gone to be recycled, which is nice. So I've got a new number. The fact I had some Vistaprint cards made up with my emergency number, which I was going to make my main number again when my current contract finishes, that's not annoying in the slightest. Okay, I think I'm getting to the end of what I can stand to do myself. So I'm thinking about doing something on May the 4th to celebrate the fact that a lot of Star Wars fans celebrate May the 4th be with you. Now, I don't particularly like Star Wars. I've been taking pictures of all my old Star Wars stuff and realise I've got a hell of a lot. And I was going to put it on eBay as one job lot and sort of do something around that. And then I realised, you know, it's a very well doing stuff like that for art's sake, like Michael Andy, who destroyed all his possessions. But at the end of the day, he wasn't happy at the end of it. Oh, yes, you get these arty people going, oh, it's a blind piece by Michael Andy and all that. They didn't help pay off his debts when he was in debt afterwards, did they? He had to bloody give himself a cramped hand from doing these teeny tiny intricate little sketches of plants to be able to pay off his debt. Bloody permanently injured himself. So anyway, we'll see. We'll see. I mean, I'm up for destroying cheap things. You know, I've got a lot of Star Wars VHSs here I rescued from a charity shop that was closing down. And the one in Maidstone, unfortunately. Okay, well, I'm going to get Men Without Hats, Pop Goes the World to play out. I'm going to play it in its entirety. There's a nice guy called Tarek on the MA who's not on BA at Maidstone at the moment. He does lots of film showings around the idea of the end of the world. So, okay. turn it up a bit. He would love this track. Oh dear. It's me with my Vectrex. Something. We did a lot of this. Tapescape. It's beautiful. Okay, right. Take a VHS apart and you snap off one of the sides here. And you just hold it up like this. Oh, try to get your thumb. It's a bit tricky the first bit. Set this up. You're seeing a lot more of that in the future, believe me. There's Doug and Claire. Lovely. Oh wow, I wonder if this works on the webcam, hang on. Still haven't learned. Whoa! Okay, no.